because your brain is a little bit faster than our brain at the moment. We've been there, we've done that, but we want to be very clear and sit here and listen. But I, you know, look, I tell you what woke Māori them up since the 1975 landmark. Because you people were quite happy in what the Crown was doing and what the Māori Land Court was doing to you. And we marched. This man here, he walked all the way.
Mind you, he provided the van, didn't he?
But his two brothers...
You haven't fixed it up yet.
His two brothers actually were on the march. Dave and Bonzo. And my husband, who was the carver of the pavilion. But it awoke the country. And since then, the judges of the Māori Land Court have been busy trying to sort out Ngā Pendua, Ingao, Engari, e Teka. But the thing is, with us, we still go to that Māori Land Court to sort ourselves out. You know, we're talking to the Tiratanga that we can handle our own kawana or whatever it is. But, you know, you can understand how the frustration of our people. We are properly frustrated. We are properly confused. Not with us. We say we're confused within ourselves, but because the kāwana has actually done this to us. And what happened to our people, even the young ones, are all so confused. I heard someone say they're taking their lives. But I'm not going to say, and I'm not going to agree to it. It's up to the kāwana to fix what they've done. A lot of stuff that we have to push the kāwana to fix their own rangarua, what they've done to us with our hinihoro. You know, once upon a time, you know, everybody was in the job, earning money. We can't say that anymore. So we now have turned to say our lands are lying idle. You know, Pamiru here itself used to be all a farming area, used to be all a garden mahinga mama, not anymore. Because what happened? The government came here and said, off you go to Auckland. So they said, okay, we'll sell our house. So, you know, frustration is a real mama
that's coming in our people. They're not even listening to that.
My grandfather was sitting here, who's over there. Kerimia Te Wake tried to do that over here, you know. He gave some good talk to his people here. I wasn't even born. But from my mother, and some people, even my own people, don't know who was this Kerimia Te Wake. He was my tūpuna, who was Te Oki and Pirihua, who actually, where Pamiru is from. And you know what I'm going to say to my tūpuna for holding on to this moment with the tahi e o ngā whare tapu o ngā puri. So please don't say, I'm te rara, what am I doing in a ngā pui hui, because we're holding on to your fellow's whare tapu. Because all of your mama is gone. You know, when we talk about the rangatiratanga, hey, don't meet it to your mama anymore, because the crown is. You know, and me, I don't know whether it's come from my mom, but I believe that the land is our rangatiratanga, our family. So I'm frustrated because a lot of us don't have land anymore. Our family is gone. The crown has taken it. You know, when you talk about, oh, I own land over there, you don't own it. Don't believe it, because you're paying rates for it. When you pay rates, your land is not yours. I would think everybody in this group should say today, no more paying rates. I'm going back to my rangatiratanga. Why should I pay rates? But if you pay rates, you agree with the system. So, you know, believe that. Are you paying rent for your land? And this kaitiaki tanga, forget about that kupu kaitiaki. You're not a caretaker of your own land. Come on. got your land from your ancestor, not from anywhere else. Wherawaku, ne. Please, we are frustrated. So if anyone gets up, like in the whare, where is she? Like in the whare, she's frustrated to the boss. She wants to try and see a mea papai mo te marae o Waitangi. Marae o Waitangi is in a bad way. It's in a bad way. Whakamana hau ki te hari ki reira I ngā rā nui. Whakamana na te mea a pāpu katoa ko Porohau katoa. Let's put it right.